mango in this mangroves or in this wetlands for nesting their what you can say the eggs of the olive ridley turtles, right? So obviously this was an hunting ground for the poachers before it was declared as a Ramsar Convention site. So many people used to go and capture the olive ridley turtles during this nesting season, and that is why now this what you can say the Ramsar Convention site, this or that is Bhitarkanika, has been protected now. And here these olive ridley turtles are not allowed to capture by the people. Fine. So the collecting and marketing the turtles and their eggs is banned in India now since 1983. So got it why the Bhitarkanika is a very, very important conservation site in India?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Check it. Now, going back to the list of Ramsar Convention site again. After the Bhitarkanika, we'll see Bhoj wetland, which is located in the Madhya Pradesh. In the Bhoj wetlands, we have white storks, black naked storks, and bar-headed geese and spoonbills. These are the important birds which are found in the Bhoj wetland, which is located in the Madhya Pradesh. Then Chandartal, Himachal Pradesh. This is again one of the important wetland in the Himachal Pradesh. Then Chilka Lake. Again, Chilka Lake is again one of the very, very important wetland, which is located in Odisha. So Chilka Lake is a brackish water lagoon. So anyone knows what is the meaning of lagoon? Brackish water lagoon. Lagoon means, so when there is a high tide or high tide, so some of the mean sea level water, what you can say, enter into the land, and that water is trapped back again when there is a low tide. So Chilka Lake is a brackish water lagoon spread over the Puri, Khurdan, Ganjam districts of the Odisha state in the east coast of the India. At the mouth of the Daya River. All of you will go and check it out. All of you know what is the location of the Chilka River in the Odisha coast? And it is located at the coast of the Odisha. So it is the largest coastal lagoon in India and the second largest lagoon in the world. The lagoon hosts over 160 species of the bird in the peak migratory season. So many birds come to this region, country. Birds as far as the Caspian Seas, Lake Baikal, Aral Sea, other remote parts of the Russia, that is Kyrgyz steppes of the Mongolia, Central Southeast Asia, Ladakh and Himalayas comes here. These birds travel great distances. Migratory birds probably flow much longer routes than the straight lines. So possibly up to 12,000 kilometers to reach Chilka Lake. So in 1991, Chilka Lake was designated the first Indian wetland of international importance under Ramsar Convention. So what is the significance of this Chilka Lake? Chilka Lake was the first wetland which is declared as a wetland of international importance under the Ramsar Convention. So in November 2002, the Ramsar Wetland Conservation Award was presented to Chilka Development Authority for outstanding achievement in the field of restoration and wise use of wetlands and effective participation of local communities in these activities. So white-bellied sea eagles, grey-legged geese, purple moron, jacona, flamingos, egrets, grey and purple herons, Indian roller, storks, then white ibis, spoonbills, Brahmani ducks, then show whalers, spintails. These are all the birds which comes to these areas. And that is why Nalbana was notified in 1987 and declared a bird sanctuary in 1973 Wildlife Protection Act. So Irrawaddy dolphin, this is again one of the important, what you can see, the plant which is found in the Chilka Lake. So Irrawaddy dolphin, remember Irrawaddy dolphin, Orchella, what you can say, brave, where is this? Is the flagship species of the Chilka Lake. Chilka is home to the only known population of the Irrawaddy dolphins in India. So Irrawaddy dolphins, Irrawaddy actually a river in Myanmar. So the dolphins which are found in the Irrawaddy river, that is found in India also. In India, it is found in Chilka Lake. That is why the Chilka Lake is very important. And one of the only two lagoons in the world that are home to this species. It is classified as critically endangered. So Irrawaddy dolphin are classified as a critically endangered. in 5 of the 6 places it is known to live. Okay? So that is why the Shilka Lake is very important. It is declared in 1981 as a international wetland of importance as per the Ramsar Convention site. Then there is one more site that is called as Dipor Bil. Dipor Bil, which is in Assam, a fresh water lake in former channel of the Brahmaputra River. A great biological importance and also essential as the only major storm water storage basin of the city of Guwahati. It is located in Guwahati. So the Bil is a staging site on migratory flyways, and some of the largest concentration of aquatic bird in Assam can be seen, especially in winter. So some globally threatened bird species are supported, including the spot-billed pelican, lesser and greater adjacent stork, and the bear sponchard. The 50 fish species present provide livelihoods for a number of surrounding villages and nymphaea, nuts and flowers. So that is why this is important. So you just check it out. This Dipor Bil, which is located in the Assam, is again one of the important international convention, international Ramsar Convention site. Then East Kolkata wetlands, then Harike wetlands, which is located in Punjab. This is also one of the important sites. Then Hokkira wetland, which is located in Jammu and Kashmir. Then Kanjili wetland. Then Kewaldev National Park. This Kewaldev National Park is again very important conservation site in India, which is located in Rajasthan. So you have to go read this in detail. That is why this Kewaldev National, the park is important. So a complex 10 artificial seasonal lagoons varying in size, situated in the densely populated region. Vegetation is mosaic of scrub and open grassland that provides habitat for breeding, wintering and staging migratory birds. Also supported by 5 species of ungulates, 4 species of cats and 2 species of primates, as well as diverse plants and fish species. The canal provides water for agricultural and domestic consumption. Cattle, water, buffaloes graze on the sites. A field research station exists, placed on the Montrexo record. Montrexo record, Montrex record means what? Is a register of the wetland sites list of the Ramsar Convention. So, which is also, so you need to remember that this is also called as Montrex record. It is a register of the wetland sites as per the Ramsar Convention. Fine? Check it. So, next is Keshupur Miani Community Reserve, which is in Punjab. Then Kolleru Lake, again one of the important the Ramsar Convention site. Question has been asked about the Kolleru Lake, which is a boundary between Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. You have to go and check it out. Loktak Lake of Manipur is again one of the famous. You have to read about the Loktak Lake also, which is found in Manipur. Questions have been asked related to the Loktak Lake in UPSC previous year exams. So just check it out. All of you go and read it out. I'm just giving you the names which are important, which you need to go and read in detail from Wikipedia. Fine. So Loktak Lake, then Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary is not required. Nandur Levit, then Nawab Ganj is not again important. Point Calimar Wildlife and Bird Sanctuary, yes, you see it out. Point Calimar, which is also the Kanyakumari, is also called as Point Calimar Wildlife Bird Sanctuary. You have to read about this. Then Pong Dam, which is located in the Himachal Pradesh. You have to read this also. Then Renuka Lake, which is again found in Himachal Pradesh. Rupar Wetland, which is again found in Punjab. Rudrasagar Lake, which is in Tripura. Then Saman Bird Sanctuary, Uttar Pradesh. Samaspur Bird Sanctuary in Uttar Pradesh. Sambar Lake in Rajasthan. You have to read this also, Sambar Lake. Then Sandi Bird Sanctuary, Uttar Pradesh. Check it. Sundarban Wetland, which I have already seen. Mansar and Surinsar lakes in Jammu and Kashmir. Then So Muriri, which is located in Ladakh. So Muriri Lake, which has been shown in the Three Idiots movie. So this is again one of the important. Yeah, this is again one of the important lake in the of the Ladakh. So you have to check this also. Why it is significant? Then going down, Vembanad is again one of the very important Ramsar Convention site, which is found in Kerala. Then Wooler Lake of Jammu and Kashmir. So all these sites you have to go and check it out, because the questions have been asked on the Ramsar Convention sites in India, their significance and their importance. Fine? Chali, any doubts about it? Hello, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Chali. So, yes, Chandrasekhar.
One thing. Sir, sometimes they will ask artificial legs, like,
now, which among the following are the artificial leg, right? So I don't think UPSC has asked. Yeah, there was one question which was asked in the 2017 or 2016 prelims exam. The question was asked, but yes, there are only few artificial legs in India, so that question has been asked. So
yes,
when you read these all topics, you will come to know which are artificial and which are not artificial. Fine.
Okay.
Sir, yes. Today which topic do you read, sir, today?
Ramsar Convention sites, जो अभी मैंने बताए सारे Ramsar Convention sites की significance क्या है वो पढ़ना है, वो देखना है.
Okay, thank you.
Fine.
Thank you, sir. Okay, sir.
So I'm stopping here today. Tomorrow is Friday, right? Thursday. Tomorrow yes. is Friday. So let us see. Yes. Tomorrow onwards, a lockdown is declared in our city now. So I will just check it out whether it is possible for me to take a class tomorrow or not. I will let you know on the group. So if possible, we will continue tomorrow. Fine?
Okay, sir.
Check.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.